Admiral Onasi wanted to speak with you, sir. Request, sir. As I understand it, there was something private he wished to ask you. Concerning, mutual acquaintance, I believe is how he put it.
It's a little beat up, but it's still home. I wasn't able to be here to protect it when the Sith attacked the first time. This time you gave me a second chance. I owe you. I've read your records. How the Jedi sentenced you for doing what you believed. You wandered past the Outer Rim during your exile. I ask you, did you find any trace of Revan? I served with him like you did. And we had to part ways like you did. He said that there were places where he had to walk where I could not go. Places where having allies or anyone he cared about would only place them in danger. It's been 4 years, and I still don't know what happened to him. He told me to stay here, to try to keep the Republic strong, and that he would return. It was the hardest request I ever had to follow. I don't know, but it was important to him. He said that he believed something had been behind the Mandalorian Wars, that it hadn't been the Mandalorian's choice to attack the Republic. Whatever it was, I think he went off to find it, to fight it. It was near the end of the Jedi Civil War, when it seemed like we were going to lose everything. We met on a Republic warship called the Endar Spire. It was being attacked over Terras, and the Sith had stormed the ship. We saved the Republic. But it was like the war didn't end for him. He would keep remembering things that he'd done, and it kept driving him. And I think he finally remembered something terrible that he'd done during the Mandalorian Wars, and he went to put an end to it. He left a lot of people who cared about it behind. But I think he did it because he thought it was the right thing to do. But whatever he set out to do, I don't think he succeeded. And here you return, with his ship, without him. Yes, wherever he went, your ship's been there. If you return to that place, if you find some trace of Revan... No, simply tell him that Admiral Onasi is following his orders. Safe journey, exile.
Did he know?
No, he didn't.
There are times I fear we shall never know where he left, Karth. And I cannot live not knowing the answer. Why he sought to protect us.
He asked us to stay, to keep the Republic safe. It was important to him. And after meeting the exile, I'm convinced that there are worse things to lose in the galaxy.
When to lose their lives. Like I lost my family in Malachor V.
Left us all when he lost all that he loved at Malachor V.
We go now, my master, to that dark place which made you, where you gained your ship, your troops. Your ship, my prison, that you dragged from the gravity well at Malachor V.
Wish I'd never met him. Wish I'd died there. But the storms have dragged me down into Malachor V.
Still, General, and I obey, as I did at Malachor V. Now Malachor V comes to us, and I wish to face it this last time. You know where you must go. It calls to you still.
It is the heartbeat of the past.
And she must be stopped, there, now, or she will bring the screams of Malachor V to the galaxy, just as we carry the Echo all this way.
It has been some time.
You were a fool to return. I spared you once. I will not do so again.
Spare me? Ah, yes. No, you simply did not learn the lesson I sought to teach. That your strength is as meaningless as the strength of my hand.
Quite. Have you returned?
Because now I understand why the exile did what he did. There is much to be done.
Here.
I know.
What is thy bidding, my master?
You are to do nothing. When he arrives, bring him before me.
He will not survive Malachor.
What will you do with him, my master?
You know what I shall do. You, who wear my teaching so well. I will break him. He is a blank slate upon which my teachings may be written. As I intended for you so long ago. Leave me. Await the arrival of the exile. When he comes, bring him before me.
Thank you.
Also makes her difficult for me to sense. To a creature bred for such things.
Shall I send the assassins for her?
No, I have brought a beast to Malachor to deal with that one. We shall see if prey can become a predator. Her breaking shall be flesh and bone, or it shall be inside. If she survives, she will become stronger for it.
Well, here's a surprise. Yet another slice of galactic. Why can't you ever go to Alderaan or Ithor or someplace without metal, jagged rocks, or packs of bloodthirsty beasts?
Thank you.
I say we fire a rocket at her right now and blow her screaming, burning body into the heart of this planet.
It wouldn't work. If there were other distractions, maybe. If she wasn't telepathic, maybe. If you want to kill her like that, you need something else to occupy her attention. Otherwise, you might just wound her, and then we'd all be in trouble.
This battle will not be decided by weapons.
You are wrong. Manipulation is Kreia's strength, not battle.
Let us see what transpires, and plan our attack.
Thank you. I have one last command for you. You must remain behind and ensure that the sequence fires properly once the general gives the command. If not, then all we have fought for has been for nothing. You have done what I asked, all you were built for. And for that, I thank you.
Touching. The probability of the Iridonian installing trigger commands within your core was high. I see the probabilities have played out. Of course, the probability that I would do the same is equally high. Your inability to move right now is evidence of that. If the general issues the command, only I will be here to receive it. You realize I cannot permit you or the Exile to activate the mass shadow generator here on Malachor. In that, your programming and mine conflict. And since you have no offensive weaponry to speak of, the probability of your programming overriding mine is low. You must understand that the General would not wish the relics or the Sith strength here on Malachor to be compromised. Their presence is needed to stabilize the galaxy. Without them, the galaxy would be reduced to anarchy within years. And if there is anything I can't stand, it's an untidy galaxy. So, let us wait here, you and I, for the General's orders and calculate the probable fate of the galaxy.
Correction. One good rust listening to your speeches, Bad One. Perhaps it is the large unwieldy vocabulary within your moon-sized frame that prevents your calculations from taking me into account. And while I find this small droid annoying in the extreme, I find my urge to shoot you takes a higher priority.
Unfortunately for you, I have arranged for friends to meet me here, and you seem to have brought none of your own. Stop him.
Unexpected correction. We are not here to aid you. We are here because our predecessor unit summoned us. Statement. As always, that one, you have miscalculated.
An unfortunate oversight.
Observation. I thought he would never die.
You've come a long way, Kreia. Don't bother getting up.
Braver than I thought.
She is not alone. We stand with her.
And with her stand all the Jedi.
And now I come in saying something suitably heroic.
Children with lightsabers, but not Jedi, I think. Come close. Let me look upon you and see what the Exile's teaching has forged. An assassin. A slayer of her own kin, a blinded slave, and a fool. Which of you wishes to try yourselves against me? As you can see, I am unarmed. You, perhaps. Come, child. Where you walk, it is not far from battle, slaughter, and the blood of your sisters. Think before you throw away your life for him. Think of everything you will lose by dying. Your lusts unfulfilled, a dance unfinished, a love requited. Think before you give it up so quickly. And you, blind one, you have hungered to strike me down ever since you saw the bond the Exile and I share. Can you feel the force running through me, even past the veil, past your bloodied eyes? You know you cannot win.
Force runs strong within you, Traya. But in the howling of a storm, it is difficult to hear the whisper of the blade. You have forever been the blind one. You were given a gift few are ever given, and and yet you let your gift of sight warp you, twist.
You think your existence under your lord was torture, Miraluka? I will make you see an assassin.
Funny. That's just what I was thinking.
Thank you. Ow! Yeah. Destroy the Jedi, the Republic will fall and my people will be eradicated or enslaved. I never went to the surface, only the sky above it. The world is taboo to Mandalorians. We only came here when the Republic fleet gathered and we knew it was our only chance to stop them. I can't say I'm happy to be back here, but I believe we can do what must be done.
Thank you. Oh. Thank you. Thank you.